first serve percentages, unforced errors, backhand winners. Tennis is a data nerd's dream. Wimbledon may be the oldest tennis tournament in the world, and with its strict all-white dress code and strawberries and cream, it's steeped in tradition. But it isn't just about heritage. Somewhere beneath the courts, in a dark bunker, the All England club has partnered with IBM and is using artificial intelligence and data analytics to inform the media, the players and their coaching staff, and the fans.
Wide in, forehand in, body in, backhand in.
It starts with data collection. County-level tennis pros monitor every game at the championships closely, even those on the outside courts. Huge data sets are then processed here.
We last year captured 4.8 million data points, and then in this system you can also have all of the leaderboards for all of the tournaments, and then this data set goes back to 1877. So if you want to ask us a query about any data point at Wimbledon in its entire history, we can give you an answer.
Artificial intelligence is used in a messenger app within Facebook Messenger. This is designed to bring personalised content to new audiences. The AI platform is also helping Wimbledon's content team become more efficient. Crowd noise and players' fist pumps are analysed, so video highlight packages are now produced just 5 minutes after a game is finished. It's all part of Wimbledon's move into media. This is the first year its new broadcast unit has taken over from the BBC as the host broadcast operation.
One of the things that's driven us to do things differently this year is, with Wimbledon being more like a broadcast organisation as well as a sporting event, a lot of their outside courts now are available for streaming. They can be provided to a broadcaster who might want to pick up feed for the Bulgarian player playing on court 5. If you're part of a community in a WhatsApp group, or you're a part of a community in Facebook Messenger, then you can be having those conversations informed by this whilst watching the tennis, whilst eating your lunch, you know, the multi-dimensional lives that we live.
Is there a danger that people are almost distracted with all this other stuff that's going on? They're going to miss the action, they're going to miss what they've come to the sport for in the first place?
We live in a very fast-paced environment, and there's a huge amount of sport going on. There's some football tournament apparently going on in Russia. What Wimbledon have got to try and do is provide the highest quality content they've got and they can provide to where the fans are, so they have the opportunity to grab their attention.
The level of data that fans can now access is deeper than ever. But Wimbledon reckons it has something for everyone, and that it can increase engagement and bring the business up to date while staying true to its traditions.
For some people, it is the ins and outs and the statistics of the game. For others, it's just that it happens once a year and it's very British and you get to have strawberries and pims. Even though people are maybe focusing less in their 100% attention, what we hope we're doing is sort of adding to it by providing some of these different offerings to make their experience richer. Our ambition is to keep Wimbledon relevant and celebrating our traditions, but really using innovation to do that and changing the perceptions of what people naturally think of.
Wimbledon says it's providing this service not just for the data-obsessed sport geeks, but for the casual fan as well. It might seem a little bit sad that people can't just enjoy watching a game of tennis on a single screen, giving it their entire attention anymore, but this is increasingly the reality in an age where consumers have so much choice.